Hello everyone, Justin DeLay from Reverb.com back for another episode of Intro to Synthesis. Today we're taking a closer look at modulation. Put simply, modulation is the idea of using signals generated within your synthesizer to change or shape various aspects of the sound that you're producing over time. So when we're talking about modulation, we're usually starting with an LFO, or a low frequency oscillator. That's an important word. If you remember from the very first episode of Intro to Synthesis, we took a hard look at the oscillators that generate sound in your synthesizer. And a low frequency oscillator is the same thing. It's basically a circuit that generates a waveform. The difference between an LFO and a regular oscillator is the low frequency part of the LFO. Basically, all that means is it's doing the same thing that an oscillator is doing, generating a waveform. It's just generating it at a lower frequency. Same basic idea, you're generating a waveform, but instead of listening to it as sound, we're using it as a control signal within our synthesizer. The most basic LFO waveform is going to be a sine wave. It's a very smooth, continuous signal. And when you use an LFO with a sine wave, in this case to modulate a filter, you're going to get a smooth ramp up and down. Now, we can do it more slowly. Or we can do it really fast. One quick note here. On this specific synthesizer, to control the LFO, it's attached to the modulation wheel. And this control setup is pretty standard on many synthesizers. And the idea is that you've got your LFO generating its wave, and the amount that you dial up the modulation wheel determines how much of that LFO is influencing, in this case, your filter cutoff. So again, and that's really cool because it allows you to dial in and out that LFO, that modulated sound in your playing, and it can become very, very expressive really quickly. One of the cool things about LFOs is that just like other oscillators, they can generate multiple different waveforms. So we've been listening to a sine wave. Now let's listen to a ramp down saw wave. You can do the opposite as well. This is a ramp up saw wave. And then finally, again, just like a regular oscillator, we also have a square wave. Generally speaking, and I encourage you to experiment, I like using sine waves from an LFO at a pretty slow speed to do gradual modulations of things like the filter to add just a little bit of movement over time to your sound. And I like to use a square wave at a faster tempo to replicate the sound of like a sequenced bass line, or even sometimes you can get it to sound almost like it has a delay on the tail. And the trick there, you've got your square wave LFO at a relatively fast rate, essentially as if it was like the delay time on your delay. And then if we remember from the previous episode, we have our filter envelope set up with a long decay, and then you've got the LFO also doing this to the filter, and it replicates the sound of delays that are getting more dull as they drift away over time. Another classic use of LFOs and modulation is to create pitch vibrato. Usually, the singer or the guitarist starts with a pure note and then adds vibrato at the end. We can recreate that using a sine wave LFO at a relatively quick speed and then dialing in the amount of modulation again with the mod wheel. It sounds like this. Let's take the idea a little further. Let's change the shape of the LFO and slow it down to create some classic siren and synth effects sounds. Okay, a third awesome way to use an LFO is to modulate the wave shape of a square wave. And that's called pulse width modulation. And it sounds like this. Let's listen to different waveforms of the LFO modulating the wave shape of the square wave. Tips on this. With a sine wave LFO and a medium speed, you can replicate a bit of the sound of a chorus effect on your synthesizer. In my experience, that trick works better on higher register sounds versus lower sounds. And again, going back to one of my favorite tricks, if you set your LFO pretty slow to be modulating the pulse width of your square wave, you can get a really organic change in timbre that is subtle but adds a real interesting bit of movement to your sound. Okay, so that was a quick look at using modulation in a synthesizer. We took a look at the LFO, its various wave shapes, and how it can be applied to filters and pitch and wave shape to add a tremendous amount of life and movement to your sounds. I'm Justin DeLay from Reverb.com. Thanks for watching.